tracks to go back the way the helicopter had come from. And you'll see, if you look in the upper left corner, the altitude of the helicopter begins to lower or reduce 1,500 feet. And we see it get to 1,300 feet. And that's about where we see the radar tracks stop moving. That is approximately the impact site where the helicopter struck that hillside this morning. We've been piecing together the movements of the aircraft leading up to this, all the way back to Orange County, where the helicopter first transitions into LA airspace, and we can pick it up on that radar track. It traveled north along the 110 freeway through downtown. In fact, it appears it flew directly over Staples Center, then flew along the 5 freeway northbound, but stopped just to beam the LA Zoo. And that's where we were able to pull up some air traffic control conversations between the pilot and the Burbank Airport control tower, where the pilot of this helicopter wanted special clearance through the San Fernando Valley. The visibility was poor, below the minimums that would typically be required for what they call a VFR, or visual flight rules flight. Helicopters are allowed to fly through that anyway under different rules called special VFR rules, and the pilot and the air traffic controller have a conversation about that. In fact, it took about 15 minutes to get that clearance, and you can see on the radar track this helicopter making donut circles around the 5 and the 134 waiting for the clearance. Then they get it. The pilot proceeds north along the 5 freeway, west along the 118. He has several conversations with air traffic controllers discussing the poor visual conditions and the need for these special VFR rules. And then the radar track shows you what we just showed. The helicopter transitions south across the San Fernando Valley, picks up the 101 freeway, turns west, and then as the pilot reached the Las Virgenes Canyon Road area, made a decision to make a U-turn. We can see in the radar track the helicopter climbs quite a bit, all the way up to 2,300 feet, begins that left turn, and then as it turns left, impacts the hillside. We'll send it back to you.